What's up everyone, it's Craig from The Rusty Fig, and today we're talking suckers on fig trees. So this is just a quick video to show you the impact of letting suckers grow on the growth of the tree, as well as how it impacts the shape and structure of the tree as well. I'm going to bring you in close and show you how these suckers have grown. You can see there's one, two, three pretty decent ones that have put on. This one has one, two, three, four, already busy putting out its fifth node. Now if we go up the stem to the top of the tree, you'll see not much. There's one leaf and there's another one just starting to come out there, but the growth is nothing compared to what's coming out the bottom. So now that you've visually seen the difference between sucker growth and normal growth with suckers, you can very clearly see that there's a big difference in the amount of growth, how vigorous the plant is. There are already fruit buds on the suckers. There's a few swelling on the main stem, but you really can't compare the two whatsoever. The trees, if I bring you into the background here, these are some of the trees that have been let to grow that don't have any suckers, and you can see the leaves are big. They are pretty good, healthy fruit buds already forming. So the impact of suckers on growth is pretty phenomenal. However, and this is where we move into the next phase of structure and future growth of the tree. If you have pretty good suckers, you need to make a decision what you want to do with your tree. If you leave it as is, ultimately the main stem will catch up. It'll be a little bit weaker, but it will. The suckers will actually catch up to it very quickly. When you're looking at 15, 20 centimeters growth in 2 weeks compared to none. So they'll pretty quickly catch up to each other. Then what you can do if you decide to leave your suckers is to let them grow out, and then you'll have a bushy multi-stem clump form fig tree. If it's potted, you have a lot more control over nutrients, water, all of those things. If it's in the ground, you can expect to have very variable growth. Not all of the shoots are going to put on lots of fruits. Some of them might not mature because they each have their own root system. Some might be stronger than others. They're sharing resources. So in essence, you never really get the amount of control that you do as you do with single stem plants. On the other hand, what you could do is completely get rid of these. Once you get rid of those, then you're diverting all the energy from the root base and the shared roots growth into the main stem, all going back to the top. Stimulates growth, stimulates buds, fruit, all of that. So it's very much a decision on whether you want a tree style plant or whether you want a clump, bushy shaped plant. That would determine what you do with these suckers. Then thirdly, what you can do is if you decide to take out your suckers, dig into the soil a little bit and see what's underneath. This one actually has its own root base. So what you can do is you just cut it there, take the roots, stick it in a pot, and you'll be left with something like this. Your own new plant that you could give to someone, stick in the ground as another tree-shaped plant to get extra figs. Well, I hope you enjoyed that video. I hope you got some value out of it. We will be keeping these suckers for now. We're going to let them grow out, see what they do. We'll report back to you on the difference in production, the main stem versus the suckers. So we can do the experiments for you and then ultimately tell you what's best, you know, based on what your needs are. So we'll let them go and feed back to you. Thanks for watching. Hope you got some value. Please subscribe so you get the notifications of these videos as and when we pop them up. Also visit our site to see what we offer. And yeah, please comment, interact, let us know your thoughts. If there's anything you want to see, let us know. We'll cover it. Thanks, everyone.